Responsibly.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again to your favorite show and mine,
Drinking Buddies.
My name is Brian Roberts, and as always, my great friend,
Harry Thomas.
You know, it has been a long
time,
Harry.
It's been more than a month.
More than a month. You already know I've gone all the way to Portland. And had multiple cocktails
buddies.
And done an army drinking buddies with Tori.
Tori.
I couldn't wait any longer for you, man. So where have you been? Is what I want to know. I think everyone wants to know. Where have you been?
I have been decluttering and moving. We moved Peggy down here. And
now, I don't think any of the people in YouTube land even know.
We don't need to go there.
Well, listen, one of these days we'll help you to understand. But some big things are happening
big
in Harry's life. And we're super excited for him. And so in order to accompany and accommodate those big things, not very big things, we have to...
That's dying over here.
He has to accommodate some things. There's been lots of moving and he's been out of town. And so anyway, we're finally back. We did shoot another episode...
Of this drink,
before I left to go to Portland.
Correct.
And the audio screwed up, and the video was fine, but the audio was terrible, and so I figured, let's just redo it. So what drink are we doing tonight, Harry?
We are doing a drink, ladies and gentlemen. This drink dates back to the early 1930s, if not before.
Nice.
And at one time, this drink was as popular... as the martini, believe
really?
It or not. Yes.
The early 1930s, so you were high school, college?
Here we go. Hey, I'm going to ask you guys out there in TV land, did I deserve that?
Well, I don't know. Did you deserve it, Harry?
I did.
Okay.
Okay, so this drink is called the Bijou Cocktail.
The Bijou.
And typically, it only has three ingredients plus... orange bitters.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the people that does a lot of videos and mixed drinks for liquor.com, which is a great website, he suggested that back off a little bit on the green chartreuse and put in just a little bit of Campari. Nice. And he felt that smoothed out the drink a little bit.
So we're going with his particular recipe.
And this recipe is kind of a riff, if you will, on the Negroni, which again is a great cocktail.
Fantastic.
So it's typically equal parts.
All right. So let's make
it happen. So there's four of us drinking, so 1 ounce apiece.
And hey, before we get too far along, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage one last time, Dion DeRosas.
Hey!
Harry, how's it going, Dion?
Good to see you, man.
Dion is over because tomorrow is my 45th birthday, and so we're having a little party here, too. I'm assuming you're not drinking since you're going to work.
Yeah.
All right. Well, here we go. Right. So we're in the middle.
We're in the middle.
So how much per cocktail?
So 1 ounce of gin.
Right.
Per. Okay. So there's four of us drinking.
Cool.
Okay.
Good.
1 ounce of drink. 1 ounce each of sweet vermouth.
Indeed.
Okay. So we'll fill this up to the 8 level.
All right. That's starting to be a real cocktail. 8 ounces.
Well, yeah, that would be. Whoa. Okay, now here's the difference.
All right.
We're going to use three quarters of an ounce each. Typically, we would use 1 ounce of the green chartreuse.
Got it. But this time we're going to use 3/4 of an ounce.
3/4 of an ounce. And we used Bombay
Sapphire.
Sapphire gin.
Awesome.
Peggy will tell you a little story about that later on.
Cool.
So we're going to use... 3 ounces, 3/4 of an ounce times 4.
Right.
So we're going to go up to 11 ounces here.
All right. Perfect.
There we is. Green chartreuse, and there's only one place to get that.
Indeed. And then the final ingredient.
The final ingredient.
It's a little Campari.
instead of using 1 ounce each of this, we use a 3/4 ounce, and we're going to use 1/4 ounce each. So just times 1 ounce.
This four drink thing makes this calculation really easy. We should do four drinks every time, Harry.
Nice and even numbers. Yeah.
I know, right?
Yeah, nice.
We
and
just
even
drink
numbers.
Two apiece every time. That works great.
So the thought is that using the Campari rather than the orange bitters smooths out the drink a little bit, gives a little more complexity.
Indeed.
So that's where we are.
All right.
And we're going to put some ice.
Put some
carefully in here.
Okay.
And then we're going to stir this.
There you go.
Okay. Can you put some more ice in there, please?
I can.
So now we're going to stir because this is all liquor. Did you see what I just did? I hope the camera
did. I didn't see what you just did. What did you just, did you do another foul?
He lost some.
Oh, geez. Harry, again.
I don't know what's up, man.
Bigger vessels, apparently. Now you saw, you know, Tori's. I'm sure you watched the Japanese stirring technique versus the whatever wild technique that Tori was trying to show us. And I was amazed that it got the alcohol down to like 12 degrees or 16 degrees. I didn't think it would. Yeah, I had no idea. Tori knows all the science. Tori's all about the science of drinking. I'm just a guy who likes to drink, and Tori helps me. So does
Harry.
Yes, he
does.
I never get to mix the drinks. I just stand here and look pretty.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. All right.
Let's not get carried away here.
No, let's not. There we go.
So again, this drink is a riff off of the Negroni, which is a great drink.
Mm-hmm. So we had the Negroni and what was it, the Boulevardier?
Boulevardier.
Correct. And now this is the Bijou.
Bijou.
Awesome. Now, what were the differences? It's been a while.
Well, Negroni is gin, equal parts, let's see, sweet vermouth and Campari.
Right.
So gin,
right.
Sweet vermouth,
right.
And Campari, equal parts, 1-1-1.
Oh, right. And the Boulevardier was with rye?
They suggest rye.
Right.
And we use bullet rye.
Right.
But also could be with bourbon.
Okay, cool.
But, you know, so.
Oh, yeah. Now
so here, I'll let you do this.
Oh, cool. I get to
so
do the twisted.
Yes, you can be a big boy.
Great. Oh, good. Thank you so much,
ladies
Grandpa.
And gentlemen, watch my sous chef here.
Thanks, Grandpa. All right.
Okay.
Awesome.
I probably deserve that. I didn't deserve the former comment.
No, you didn't. That one you totally deserve. All right.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is
around.
It.
And here we go. Let's
here
take a
we
look
go.
At this one.
Mm. Let's show the folks what this looks like.
All right.
Yeah.
Take a good strong look at that
one. So that's what Ooh. This looks like, ladies and gentlemen.
It smells amazing. The Bijou.
Yummy.
Like that, Mr. Red?
Definitely.
It's good. Got a good upfront sweetness to it. You're right. We had the Bijou before, and it was good. It had a little, for me, too much initial gin bite, which I am now becoming quite the connoisseur of gin. As a matter of fact, when we were in Portland, we visited Aria Distillery, or it's
okay.
Matt, and it was two guys named that were the name of the company, but the Aria gin that they have there was unbelievable. Portland gin. Delicious. So I'll bring some and we'll put it on the show.
You didn't bring any down.
Well, when I was there, I only had one bag, no hard sides, and to get it in the bag would have destroyed it. I would have just carry-ons, but when I'm driving up for Thanksgiving, so I will have plenty of room
to
bring back some good spirits. So, so what do you think?
It's nice and smooth.
Yeah, it is.
Nice and smooth.
There's no corners.
That little, exactly. Very balanced.
Mm. No, very good.
The orange.
I like the orange twist on the top. Just gives it a little, just a little tiny bit.
And that
then,
aromatic.
And then the Campari has, I think, just a tad of orange in it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and if you're not going to do the orange bitters, then having the orange twist kind of finishes
and
that citrus note out.
And the Campari.
And the, of course, yeah.
What do you think?
Oh, I love it.
Cool. She loves it. That's all that matters.
Well, as you drink it, you're also getting the aroma from the skin.
Absolutely. Yeah, so it just kind of replaces the bitters with that. Yeah. So it makes it actually a much fresher tasting drink.
Yeah, I think so. I like it. I think this version of this drink,
definitely
using the Campari instead of the orange bitters. But I think I'll make one at home and we can compare it.
Indeed. Yeah. Give it a shot. I think we should make a few.
Dozen.
So remember, as always, we here at Drinking Buddies are always drinking responsibly, and you should too. So try this at home or wherever you want to try it. I mean, if you're on a park bench, I don't really care. But try it. Tell us what you think. Put your comments in the fields below. And
you got any, like it. Well, I remember one thing that you said, is that we do these cocktails here, and we're very careful about measuring carefully, using good ingredients, using fresh ingredients, doing our best to put it in, you know, good, clean ice.
Yep.
And then, and you like it. And then you go to a bar and you order it, it's different.
It's true. As a matter of fact, when we were in Portland, Tori and I were talking about this, that you can really taste, now that we've done this 60 times... you can really taste when the bartender isn't measuring.
Mm-hmm.
And when we went to see Jeffrey Morgenthaler in the cavern in Portland, he measures everything out. Every single thing is measured perfectly, and that's what you—that's how you get a balanced drink. If you're drinking crappy well drinks, you know, then okay, let's just splash it in there. Who cares? But you know, if you really care, you got to measure. And I agree that, that when you do measure, it makes all the difference in the world.
Yeah, it does. Anyway, thank you.
Absolutely, thank you, and welcome back. I'm
glad we got another episode going here.
Indeed.
There it is. All right, so
and Dion.
And so,
cheers, ladies and gentlemen.
Cheers, everybody, and happy 45th birthday to me.
Yes, indeed.
So, have a great rest of your week, and we will see you on the next episode of
Drinking Buddies.
See you then.
All right.
Oh, so good.
Very good.